Good morning students. Today we are see reading. Okay. Lesson number 5. Fire in a hotel. Okay. In this story, a dog saves his master's life by warning him of terrible danger. Find out how the master also saves his dog's life. John F. Brown's troubles began as soon as he walked into the garden hotel with his friend Chum. Together, they went to the reception desk. John said, "Good evening. My name's John Brown. I have booked a room here. Can I have my keys, please?" The clerk said, "You are welcome to stay, sir, but we don't allow pets in this hotel." "Pet!" exclaimed John. "Chum isn't a pet. I am blind and he's my eyes. He takes my every word. Don't you, Chum?" Chum barked. It sounded like yes. "I am sorry, sir," the clerk repeated, "but the hotel rules say." John interrupted, "Please call the manager." The manager came. He agreed at once that John and Chum could both be guests. He led them personally to their room. He described the room to John and left. The next day, there was a lot of excitement at the hotel. A reporter from a local newspaper came to interview John Brown. This is what John told him. "I was tired and went to sleep. Chum woke me up. I smelled smoke. A fire." Just then, the fire alarm went off. I felt the door of my room. It was hot, so I couldn't open it. The fire must be outside. I thought I wet some towel and put them along the button of the door. I felt my way to the window and opened it. But because I can't see, I could not climb out. I tried the phone. It was dead. A little smoke was getting past the towels. I started the coughing. I lay on the floor with Chum beside me and waited. The minutes seemed like hours. Then I heard the sound of fire engines. It was a music to my ears. I rushed back to the window, waved and shouted, "Chum!" barked. Moments later, I heard a voice. The fireman didn't want to take Chum. "It's against the rules," he said, "but I explained about the Chum." Seconds later, we were both safe on the ground. "So you saved Chum's life," the reporter said. "Yes, and he saved mine," said John. "Didn't you, Chum?" Chum barked. It sounded like yes. Okay, students. Thank you.